Which hosting
I'm looking at creating a WordPress website.
Are they better than their web plans?
Okay, I get it. You want to know which hostinger plan to buy for a WordPress website. And since I've been doing this for quite some time now, and by this, I mean hoarding websites, so let's just say I've tried out a couple of hostinger plans myself. All of them, actually. This is great news for you, because now I know all three of these options, they're the same three plans, just named differently. The AI tag means nothing. So I'll show you which plan to get, why you should get that plan, and how to configure it so your WordPress instance actually uses the full capabilities of your server. Because the default configuration, that ain't it, chief. Now, the good part is that I already have all of the plans. So theoretically, I just create a WordPress website on all three plans, then I do a speed test, and I find out that they're almost identical. Huh. Well, the problem is, I'm doing a speed test with just one user, so these plans just aren't getting stress tested enough. I need to bump these numbers up. But if I try to send 1000 bots to really test these sites, something weird starts happening. They all get redirected. That's the hostinger black hole DDoS protection kicking in, determining my traffic is invalid, rightfully so because these are bots, and redirecting it away from my site to save my website. Now, in real life scenarios, this is a great feature, but for what I'm doing here, which is testing which plan is the best, they're really not making it easy for me. I'll need to get a little bit more technical. Essentially, you want three things from your WordPress hosting plan. 1. Lightspeed web server architecture. Why? Because you get server-level full page caching. While this is a big mouthful of words, essentially Lightspeed takes a snapshot of your finished page and serves that copy to visitors without even waking up WordPress. Your database doesn't get touched, your plugins don't have to run, so your website is a lot faster. Think of it like this. Every time a customer orders a dish, a chef could make it from scratch, or he could have made it beforehand, keep it warm, and immediately serve it to the customer upon request. That instant meal is serving your customers from cache. So, 2, you need object cache. Because if Lightspeed is the pre-made dish for our regular visitors, what happens when someone needs a special order, one that the chef didn't have prepared? That's where object cache comes in. It's like having all of your ingredients perfectly chopped, measured, and organized in little bowls before you even start cooking. So even if you need to make something from scratch, it's much faster. This type of cache is used for website elements that just can't be made into a one-size-fits-all copy. For example, checkout carts, because the content of the cart is always different. And 3, you want at least 50 PHP workers in your plan. Think of PHP workers as the employees at our restaurant. Even if the food is made instantly, it has travel time from kitchen to the customer. The more workers you have, the more simultaneous customers you can serve. If you only have one employee and there's 100 customers, it doesn't matter how fast the food is made, the customer will still think your restaurant is slow. And I hope by this point you do understand that this theoretical restaurant is your website. And this whole cache chain of command is exactly what we want from our hosting plan, so we need to make sure the plans offer these features. Now, taking a look at the hostinger plan offerings, the cheapest plan does not offer object caching and it only has 40 PHP workers. That's a no-buy from us. The most expensive option, however, Cloud Startup, has everything we need and 100 PHP workers, double our needed amount. So when you're just starting out, essentially these resources will go wasted, essentially wasting you money. So the boring answer is that out of all three of these plans, the option recommended by Hostinger itself is actually a good recommendation.
Boo, boring.
You didn't uncover a huge secret on how Hostinger is a conspiracy trying to trick us all with the wrong plan. I know. I know it is boring, but yeah, it's a good recommendation. But what it's not good at is the default setup configuration. That's why I'm gonna buy a plan for myself, so I have a fresh copy, and I'll go through the setup steps step by step, showing you how to properly configure it, because the default configuration, it's kinda trash tier. By the way, do keep in mind that you do get 10% off by using the link in the description together with the code Emit.Reviews. And after you're done with your purchase, let's get through the initial setup, making sure your WordPress instance is as good as it can be. First of all, choose whether the website is for you. Next, I'll check that I will be creating the website myself, but if you have an existing one, you can choose the migrate option and Hostinger will transfer your existing website to Hostinger free of charge. And now, of course, we'll be using WordPress. Duh. Think of the login name and password for your WordPress account. Let's skip the pre-made bloat for now and create a blank website. Here's where you can claim your free website name. I'll go with emit.wordpress.com and finally choose your server location. Hostinger has plenty to choose from, but your goal is choose the closest location to your target audience. So if you're gonna have customers from the United States, choose United States. If you're gonna have customers from Europe, choose a location from Europe. And then Hostinger will set everything up automatically. But first, we need to wait for it to finish. Pa, 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 and it's done. Okay, you get automatically redirected to your WordPress dashboard, but we're not ready for this dashboard just yet. There's so much work to do. So click on Hosting Plan to go back to your Hostinger control panel and click on Manage next to your hosting service. First of all, we want to upgrade to a newer PHP version. Now, this isn't a must-must, but in general, newer versions will work faster, making your website experience smoother. But they can break if you're using older plugins, which you shouldn't. You shouldn't be using older plugins. You should only use continuously updated, high-reputation plugins. But there are scenarios where a PHP 8.2 might be better than 8.4. But since this is a new WordPress setup, and if you're creating a new website for yourself, you might as well lock in the 8.4, and then you'll be forced to use new and reliable stuff for the foreseeable future. It's just a good practice, so I'll go for that. The next thing is to activate all of the optimizations we have available. So navigate to WordPress, then Overview, and check if Forced HTTPS, Lightspeed, and Object Cache are enabled. If they're disabled, obviously enable them. Then next to Lightspeed, click on Change Settings and go for the Advanced option. Now, if you ever notice that your website doesn't look the way it should look, that means the CSS is probably broken. Go back to the settings and downscale to the basic version. Because what Advanced does is it tries to minimize the amount of files you have on your server by merging them together. Sometimes this merge process creates instabilities, and those instabilities lead to broken functionality on your website. Once done, go into the Performance tab, then CDN. Make sure your Hostinger CDN is active, distributing your website files through servers all across the world, so even users from Australia get a good loading speed, even if you're in America, and click Manage next to it if it is active. After that, choose the Security tab and activate Use only the latest TLS version 1.3. Okay, we're almost done here. The final step is a little bit complicated, but it does help a lot. It is to remove the WordPress CronJobs default behavior. If you don't know, CronJobs are like a WordPress to-do list. If you write a blog article and schedule it to be automatically published at 1 p.m. tomorrow, that creates a to-do item or a CronJob. The problem is that WordPress by default only activates these CronJobs if a user visits your website. So if he doesn't visit your website by 1 p.m., this job just won't trigger and your article won't be posted. So if you're not getting a lot of visitors, that means these CronJobs were always misfire and never trigger when they should. And if you do get a lot of visitors, these constant requests to check the list upon every single user arrival will slow your server down significantly. Basically, there's never a scenario where these default cron jobs are worth it. So what we'll do is we'll create a timer. Instead of checking the list every time a new user arrives, it'll simply check it once every 30 minutes or so and activate every single task once every 30 minutes. So first of all, we need to deactivate the default CronJobs. Navigate to your website control panel and look for a button called File Manager. Double click the public HTML and then find a file named wp-config. Right click and edit this item. Here you'll want to scroll down until you find the that's all stop editing line, and right before that paste in this line here that will disable the default CronJobs. Don't worry, I'll leave this command in the pinned comment down below together with everything else. So once we have this default CronJob behavior disabled, we still need to activate it some other way. So save your progress here and go back to Hostinger dashboard. In the advanced tab, you'll find a setting called CronJobs, and by selecting custom, you'll be able to give it a specific instruction. So copy and paste this line. Again, I'll leave it in the pinned comment down below. Make sure to type in your website address instead of your domain.com. And from the presets, choose twice an hour. While we're in the advanced tab, let's also navigate to the cache manager and activate automatic cache. Okay, now we're ready to access our WordPress dashboard. So first things first, Hostinger does install some bloat plugins in my mind. So I recommend you go into the plugin section and just yeet the Hostinger Easy Onboarding plugin out of there, because in my mind, every single extra plugin that you really don't need is just eating up resources. By the way, if your website still has this weird placeholder domain name and not the one you've selected, it might be an SSL issue. To quickly resolve this, navigate to your Hostinger dashboard, find the SSL tab, uninstall, then install a new SSL certificate again, and that should fix your issues. Once inside, again, I also recommend you disable XML RPC. I won't go into details here on why, but I have a separate video with the biggest beginner mistakes everyone makes. Leaving this activated is actually the number one biggest mistake you can make. By this point, we're actually done with the WordPress specific optimizations. So I'll just very quickly install a random theme and choose a design to get preloaded into my website, so I can test the performance in the most objective way possible. As you can see, this website looks pretty nice. The content is dynamic. It's definitely not like a boring, plain website that should struggle a little bit to load nicely. But as you can see, this website is an absolute beast. Loading in 0.5 seconds, scoring 100%, and getting A's all around. Now, this is our hard work that we just did paying off, configuring WordPress properly. And if you continue to follow good practices and only install plugins that you should, and not make any beginner mistakes that I outlined in this video specifically, where you should probably watch and fix all of those mistakes, you'll continue to have a great performing WordPress website using the Hostinger business plan. I know it's boring that the middle plan is the best one, but it is what it is.
It is what it is.
It is what it is.
I hope you learned something new, and I'll see you around.